What's up, everybody, and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm gonna be reviewing Karen's collaboration with ColourPop, the I Love Sarahi collection. In the past, ColourPop has collaborated with a number of creators and beauty influencers from YouTube. For the most part, all of the collaborations have been lovely, but out of all of them, I think this is by far my favorite one. I was on the website when the collection launched, and I wanted to get my hands on the PR package that they had. So that was the entire collection. I believe that one retailed for $69, but I realized very quickly that I don't really care that much about packaging and putting it on display. I just don't have the room to do that. So I just picked up the entire collection instead, which retailed for $60. It did take a little bit of time to ship to Canada. I believe it took almost two and a half weeks to finally get to my house. The collection includes two eyeshadow palettes with four pans each. One is called Cheeky and the other one is called Saucy. I actually really love the packaging. It's almost this pale sort of beige and gold exterior packaging. And then you have the actual, And then you have the actual palettes from ColourPop. Now, I do think these palettes are a little bit bulky for four eyeshadows. This is a little excessive, but I guess it does make it look really, really pretty if you do want to keep this on your vanity. The four pans inside are 0.05 ounces each, so that's 1.4 grams all together of eyeshadow product. Also included in the collection were three lip liners as well as three liquid lipsticks. Actually, one's a gloss, so technically two liquid lipsticks and a gloss. Let's start off by going through the eyeshadow palettes. For the look that I'm wearing today, I did use the palette Cheeky, which is absolutely stunning. In this palette, you do have three mattes. There is Distressed, there's this metallic color here called Vivacious, there's Freckles, and Noche. The mattes blended out so beautifully. They were so pigmented, and this color Vivacious, this metallic eyeshadow, is unbelievable. I don't know if you guys can see it as well on camera, but this really, really sparkles and shines. I am obsessed with that color. I did have a little bit of fallout when I was applying Vivacious to my eyelids, so I would suggest you use a translucent loose setting powder underneath your eyes if you're going to be doing a little bit of baking. Use a shadow shield or just do your foundation as a last step because you don't want to have to deal with getting glitter off of your cheeks. The matte colors in this palette had such incredible pigmentation, no fallout. They were a little bit on the powdery side, but I didn't mind it at all because they blended so beautifully. The color Distressed was perfect for setting my eyeshadow primer and getting something into my crease as a transition color. I next went in with Freckles and I used that to sort of smoke out my crease and help add a little bit of definition. I went in with Vivacious, obviously, all over my lid. And to add a little bit of depth and dimension to the outer corners of my eyes, I did use the color Noche, which is this very dark, almost plummy brown color. It is such a stunning, stunning shade. Noche is a color that I would love to play with all over my eyelids and really have a dark, smoky eye. But I wanted to do something that would be a little bit brighter for camera. I think it just looks a little bit better. The next palette is Saucy and it is formatted the same way as Cheeky is. You do have four colors in here. There is Heavy Glam, which is a metallic, Chic Happens, which is a matte, Lit, which is a metallic, and then Razzy, which is also a matte color. I don't know, one of those. I haven't actually put these on my eyes yet to play around with them, but they feel the exact same as Cheeky and the other pressed shadows from ColourPop. So they're very blendable, easy to work with, and they have tons of pigmentation. Heavy Glam is such a beautiful color. It is this bright sort of metallic coral, which I'm really, really obsessed with. I've seen a lot of people put this in the inner corners of their eyes. That's not exactly how I would wear the color. I feel like I would look a bit like a zombie if I did. but this is something that I would definitely put all over my lid. I would do the same thing with this metallic purple called Lit. I think that is an equally beautiful, beautiful color. It just feels so smooth and buttery. And then the two matte shades, they do feel a little bit grittier and a little bit more powdery, but that just means there's tons of pigment in there and they also blend out really, really easily. So All of these colors are absolutely stunning. I can't wait to play with them. This collection also includes 6 lip products. There are 3 pencils, and then you have 2 liquid lips and a glossy lip as well. Love the packaging that the lip pencils came in. I actually wish that this type of packaging was the exterior of the lip pencils here. I think that would have been a nice added touch, but whatever, it's just an idea. The 3 colors that these pencils come in are 951, Mamacita, as well as Curvy. So 951 is a really nice sort of neutral color. It is complementary, as is all of the other lip pencils, with the liquid lip products. 951 is a beautiful sort of neutral dusty mauve color. It is a little bit lighter than the liquid lip in 951. It's the satin that I'm wearing right now. I didn't actually expect it to be as dark as it is on my lips, but I'm gonna roll with it. I actually think it looks really good with this look. Curvy is the next lip pencil, and it's not as rosy as what 951 is. It's actually a little more on the terracotta side, but beautiful, smooth consistency, very creamy. It doesn't tug on the lips at all, just like all of the other ColourPop lip liners. And then you have Mamacita as the last color, and Mamacita is a beautiful, dark, berry-toned lip liner. I am obsessed with this color and cannot wait to wear it. I'm not a big fan of lip liners at all. I just like throwing on a quick lipstick and walking out the door. But I have noticed the more I start wearing lip liners, the longer my lipstick ends up lasting. And when the lipstick actually starts to fade, you still have a hint of the lip liner underneath. So it still looks like you've got something on your lips when you're in between touch-ups. Those were the lip pencils. And now here are these beautiful liquid lips. I love the packaging of these. So ColourPop did change out the top portion where the doe foot applicator is attached to a nice gold color rather than their typical silver, which I think is a nice added detail. The first color we're gonna look at is 951. So like I said, it's got the complementary lip color, and this is the color that I'm wearing on my lips right now. It is a little bit darker than I had anticipated, and it looks a lot lighter in the tube than it does on your lips. I hope you guys can see that. Like I said, didn't expect it to be that dark, but I'm still kind of digging it. I think what would look really nice on top of this color might be a cool lip topper. Speaking of, I think I've got one I want to test out. I just grabbed the Saint-Tropez lip topper from Jouer. This is actually a collection that I also want to test out for you guys, but I'm going to throw a little bit of this on top of my current lip. Cool. It's a little bit different. I actually think that added the perfect shine to my lips right now. Also brightened them up a little bit more so they're not as dark. Maybe it's a little more complimentary with the eye look now, but either way, I still love it. This went on a little bit grittier than what I had anticipated. It's probably because it has so much glitter in it, but I really like the way it looks on the lips. Anyways, we're not talking about Jouer. Let's go back to ColourPop. The next color I have is Curvy. So Curvy is a slightly more pinky sort of nude color, and it does have a little bit of sparkle in it. So 951 is their satin lip, which is about 80% satin and 20% matte. So it does tend to be a little more hydrating on your lips. Curvy, on the other hand, is their glossy lip. So it is meant to be a gloss, but it is extremely pigmented. It's got some gold flecks in it. It is definitely more on the nude side. I actually thought it was a little more pinky. Kind of looks like a pinky peach now that I'm looking at it, more so than a brown, but it looks stunning. It's still definitely quite smooth. I find with the glossy lips from ColourPop, they don't really last a very long time on me, especially when I'm drinking water throughout the day, so I have to reapply a little more frequently, but the same goes for the satin lips as well. And finally, the last color is Mamacita. And Mamacita, I believe, is the crown jewel of this collection. It is this beautiful dark berry color. This is definitely vampy. I think it'll be perfect for the fall. You could even rock it right now for the spring. I mean, hey, makeup is whatever you want it to be. There are no set rules. This is an ultra matte lip, so it is gonna dry down completely matte. I'm not a big fan of the ultra matte lips from ColourPop because they do feel very dehydrating. I feel like my lips shrivel up into a prune by the end of the day. So what I like to do is add a little bit of a lip gloss on top just to add a little bit of hydration back into my lips, or put a lip balm underneath before I actually apply the matte lip. That way my lips don't feel as awful by the end of the day as they would without any of that. All of the liquid lips went on smoothly. I had no issues with any of the applications. They weren't streaky. They were absolutely stunning. What I will say though about the Doe Foot applicator on a couple of them, I think the Doe Foot applicator on 951 is a little bit janky looking versus the smooth Doe Foot applicator on Mamacita. I've noticed this a few times in ColourPop products. I don't know why this is the case, but they aren't really consistent. This one just looks a lot cheaper, like it's gone through the washing machine and back, but this one over here looks a lot smoother. This could impact your application a little bit, but if it's not a big deal to you, then who cares? Overall, I'm really enjoying this collection. Love the eyeshadow palettes, love the lip products. The only thing that I think is actually missing from this collection is a nice blush. That would have been a nice added touch, and I think it would have brought everything together really nicely, but oh well, no biggie. I believe this collection is still available on ColourPop's website, so head on over there to check it out if you're interested. And that's it. I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. You can also connect with me on all of my social media. I am on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat. I'll link all of my details in the description box below. Thank you again so much for watching. I hope you are all having an amazing day no matter where you are in the world. Stay beautiful, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.